Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our General Assembly for February 8, 2021. It's good to be alive. And as usual, you know, we start with a lively chorus. So enjoy. And when we get ready to get into the word of the Lord.
God, I say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way. I say yes, Lord, yes, I will trust you and obey. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I agree, and my hands
there will be,
yes, Lord, yes. I say yes, Lord, yes, to your will and to your way.
I say yes,
Lord, yes, I will trust you. When your spirit speaks to me, with my whole heart I agree, and my answer will be yes, Lord, yes. I'm Mr. Send Down the Rain. I'm Mr. Send Down the Rain. I'm Mr. Send Down the God's glory. I'm Mr. Send Down the Rain. I'm Mr. Send Down the Rain. I'm Mr. Send Down the God's glory. Again, 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 again. I'm Mr. Send Down the Rain. Send down the rain, once I'm gonna send down the God's glory. I'm gonna send down the rain, I get no send down the rain, once I get send down the God's glory. I want to revival in my soul. I want a revival in my soul. I must oblige to the blood of Jesus. I want a revival in my soul. I want a revival in my soul. Yes. I want a revival in my soul. I must oblige to the blood of Jesus and get a revival. I'm going up on the rough side of the mountain, and I'm doing my best to make it in. I'm going up on the rough side
of the mountain,
and I'm doing my best to make it in. Again, again, boy, I saw the light. I saw the light, no more in darkness, no more in darkness. Now I'm so happy, no sorrow in sight. Praise the Holy Lord. I saw the light again, again. I saw the light. I saw the light, no more in darkness, no more in night. Now I'm so happy. No sorrow inside. Praise the Lord. I saw the light. Stand up and tell me it's the love, my Jesus. Stand up and tell me it's the love, my Lord. I want to know it's the love, my Jesus. I want to know it's the love, my Lord. Stand up and tell me it's the love, my Jesus. Stand up and tell me the love, my Lord. I want to know the love, the Almighty. I want to know the love, my Lord. Jesus, lead all three chariots. Stop and let me ride. 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 Sweet old sweet chariot, stop and let me ride. Stop and let me ride. Stop and let me ride. Stop and stop, 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 stop and stop, stop, stop and let me ride. Stop and let me ride. Sweet old sweet chariot, stop and let me ride. Stop and let me
Hi. All right. It's now 8:11, and it's time to start getting to the word. This morning, I'm going to introduce to you all Mr. Brown, Cornel Brown from the Mathematics Department. He will share the word with you this morning. Mr. Brown, it's over to you, sir. Need to unmute Mr. Brown.
Good morning, everyone. Everybody hearing me?
Yes, I'm hearing you.
Good. So the word for this month is resilience. And the theme for this morning's devotion is be a bounce back person. Now, firstly, what does it mean to be resilient? According to the Merriam-Webster dictionary, resilience is the ability to withstand adversity and bounce back from difficult life events. Here you can see I have highlighted bounce back. Now, I have highlighted bounce back for many reasons. One, at some point in our lives, we will fail at something, and from that, we will need to bounce back. Two, at some point in our lives, we will get depressed or feel less of ourselves, and from that, we will need to bounce back. And three, at some point in our lives, we will plan and plan to the point where we say, there is no way this can go wrong, and yet still we fail. And from that, we will need to bounce back. Now, some persons
all right,
may
Mr.
say
Brown,
that.
Mr. Brown, stop 1 minute. We're not seeing the screen. I'm not sure what is happening. Not seeing the screen. So start share again. So stop share and then share again. Share screen again. Yes, that's better. Yes, good. All right.
So as I was saying, some persons might say they are not strong enough, and some might even say they can't do it. Now, this is where our scripture for this morning comes in. And the scripture is taken from Joshua 1, verse 9. And it reads, "Have I not commanded you, be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go." Now, this morning, I want to tell you a story about a Colombian weightlifter. Now, before I even begin, this event is held once every 4 years. And the objective of this game is to stand with the weight and lift it above your head with extended arms. Now here, in 2004, he made his first attempt for gold. And as you can see, he failed. On his second attempt, he failed again. Now, one of the worst things about failing is that it can cause depression and allow you to feel less of yourself. Mm-hmm. on his third attempt in 2014, in 2012, some persons might say success at last. Even though he got silver here, you can see there's a lot of improvement. Now, the lesson I want to share with you this morning is that when you're a bounce back person, the greatest thing about failing is that it teaches you. Now, let's go back to his first attempt. In his first attempt here, his strategy was to lift the weight in one motion. All right? And we all know that that didn't work out well for him. Now, in his second attempt, his hands were too wide, and that caused him not to have a good grip. Now, let's observe. Let's observe his third attempt. On his third attempt, he ensures that his hands are not as wide as before to ensure that he have a good grip. He also this time changed his strategy, right? So in the first time he tried to lift it in one motion. This time he lifted to his shoulders first, then extend it above his head. So sometimes in life, when we fail, like this Colombian, it could be that our approach is wrong. It could be that our grip is off. And should we bounce back and get it right, like this Colombian, we could be unstoppable, as he won gold in 2016. So this morning, my friend Court High School family, I urge you all to be a bounce back person, as failure is just an opportunity to unlock ideas we didn't know we have. So let us pray. Heavenly Father, as I come before you in prayer, I thank you for the ability to do the simple things. Lord, I ask you that you may help us to be a bounce back person, as failing is just an opportunity to unlock ideas we didn't know we have. Lord, I pray in your holy name. Amen. All right, so the thought for this morning's devotion is, don't be afraid to fail, as failure is just an opportunity to unlock ideas that you didn't know you have. Be a bounce back person. All right, so now hand over to our principal. Don't be afraid to fail, as failure is just an opportunity to unlock ideas.
All right. Thank you, Mr. Brown, for devotion this morning. Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Joshua 1, verses 9. This morning, we are reminded to be a bounce back person. And thank you, Mr. Brown, for sharing with us your thoughts, your interpretation of the word from Joshua 1, verse 9. We're in the month of February with a number of activities this month, especially this week. We have Careers Week, Safer Sex Week. I know Miss Ellis would have spoke to us on Friday about what was happening this week. So throughout this week, what we do, we send out some reminders through the WhatsApp groups and the teachers will share with their form students as we go on this week. In terms of Career Week, I know the guidance team, they are working with that, Ms. Wade, Ms. Spark, Mr. Warren, and Mr. Thompson. So when the information, so students who are watching on YouTube and our teachers, there will be times in which our guidance counselors will call upon students to attend sessions during this week. So I know as usual, we'll give them the students opportunity to join these sessions. So you will get this schedule this week so that you'll be aware when certain group of classes will be at different sessions to celebrate Careers Week. For our grade 11 students, I know we were supposed to schedule classes for 11 FER this morning. However, in the Claremont area, we still don't have any water. We're currently trying to set up a storage system, but we have not completed. So that's why we didn't start face-to-face classes for 11 FER this morning. So I'm advising the teachers, form teachers, subject teachers of grade 11, that you will have online learning until further advice. As soon as I get any additional information, I will share it with you and then you can send it to our students. And the thought for today is, do not be frightened and do not be dismayed, for the Lord your God is with you wherever you go. Remember, we are to be a bounce back person. Failure is an opportunity to unlock ideas that we didn't know. At some point in our life, teachers, students, and other persons who are watching and listening, we would have failed at some point. But what we do with that failure after, that is what is important. And I'm just here to remind you all this morning that with this COVID-19 pandemic that we are facing worldwide, there are going to be times that we are going to be doing certain things and it might not work, but that doesn't mean that we are going to stop. But we have to try it again, try with another approach and so forth. So I just want to remind our teachers, our students, and parents who probably be watching that we're going through a phase in history where there are things that we used to do or what before COVID-19, we cannot continue at this approach as at times in which things and situations change and we have to adjust based on how we can deal with the current situation and to move forward. So I thank Mr. Brown to remind us that we must be a bounce back person. Let's get ready for the playing of the national anthem. Have a wonderful day and a wonderful week. Remember to join us back here on Friday with our General Assembly with another guest among the staff. Have a good day.